Hi friends, let us see how can we implement or how can we actually use the flow graph of DIF FFT to solve a given problem. Let us consider a problem x of n as 1, 2, 3, 4. So the given sequence over here is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let us see that the value of n is 0 over here, then 1, then 2, and then 3. Now in DIF FFT, we do not break the x of n sequence. We do not actually break into even and odd parts x of n signal. We have to write the x of n in order. So x of 0 in this case is 1, x of 1 is 2, x of 2 is 3, and x of 3 is 4. Right. Now, whenever I go up, I need to add. So 3 plus 1 is 4. 4 plus 2 is 6. Here when I come from up to down, I need to subtract. So 1 minus 3 is minus 2. 2 minus 4 is again minus 2. Correct? Now, there's no multiplier over here. So I write 4 as it is, no multiplier, 6 as it is. Now minus 2 multiplied by 1 is 2. And minus j multiplied by minus 2 is 2j. Agreed? Now, here when I go up, I'm going to add 4 plus 6, the value is 10. 4 minus 6, the value is minus 2. Here the value is 2 plus 2j. So here I'm going to write 2 plus 2j. And here it's 2 minus 2j. So it is 2 minus 2j. Right. So now whenever I write x of k, you see that this is x of 0, but then here the value of k is 2. Then we have k as 1, and then we have k as 3. So we need to rearrange the sequence. So rearrangement of the sequence will go like this. Final x of k will be equal to the first sample x of 0, which is 10. Then I will write x of 1, which is 2 plus 2j. Then I will write x of 2, which is minus 2. And finally, we write x of 3, which is minus 2 minus 2j. So this is the answer of 4-point DIF FFT. Now the viewers are encouraged to solve the same problem using the basic definition of DFT to solve and see and check whether you are getting the same answer using DIF FFT and DIT FFT. So it will always be the same, and you will see that solving using DIF FFT actually fasten up the process of getting the answers. Only thing is, we need to remember the flow graph. Thank you.